I think it is fair to ask this question. How much do you project our electric rates to go up within the next 6 months to a year? Certainly the public has a right to know. I think the media should be, with all due respect to the media, asking that question. Because this horse is not going to run without more money being spent. I can see that. The public has a right to know how much are our rates going to continue to go up, and they have gone up 59% since 2003.
My name is Gary Gates. I'm the CEO and President of oppd, and that's a very good question, and let me give you two answers to it. First one, you said the next 6 to 12 months will the rates be going up. We're not projecting any rate increases in the next 6 to 12 months. We just had one that was based on, and I know you were at the board meeting, on increasing costs unrelated to the Fort Calhoun costs. It was other issues. The whole picture for utilities going forward across the United States and probably the world is going to be looking at increased costs for a variety of reasons. Some are the pollution controls that we'll be putting on our units. It'll be replacing some of our units. It'll be going to different forms of fuel. For some of the issues that we're talking about here today, CO2 reduction, less greenhouse gas emissions, which is our strategic target going forward. So those costs will probably go up across the board for all utilities. But I can tell you that the focus for us is to reduce costs wherever possible. We take a lot of money out of the business as much as we can. We look for ways to do that on an almost daily basis so that we can make sure that the rates for projections are low as possible. We still are below the national average. We're below the regional average. And we'll continue to do that. I think it's one advantage of public power. The rates are not projected to go up in the next 6 to 12. They probably will go up in the future for a lot of different reasons that are out there, some of which we talked about in our last presentation. Sorry to interrupt you. That was appropriate to give an answer.
Since Gary mentioned that we have these really low rates, most of the power is generated by coal. I don't really consider mercury in my fish at the store or the streams a low cost. If I dump trash in the river, I'll get fined. That power plant dumps tremendous amounts of mercury into our riverways, and they do not get fined. So this low cost has a high cost in healthcare costs, fetal brain damage for that fish. So this constant rhetoric that we have low cost when we're having to pay on it on the back end, I'm sorry, it just doesn't ring at all real or true or nice or anything.
Jacob, do you have anybody else on your side? All right, well, we're going to wrap this up. The NRC staff will